Colin Kaepernick set off a firestorm in 2016 when he began kneeling during the national anthem before NFL games. The controversy prompted the president to say this last year.
Wouldn't you love to see one of these NFL owners, when somebody disrespects our flag, to say, get that son of a bitch off the field right now, out, he's fired. He's fired!
Kaepernick's protests became a lightning rod, and now 2.5 years later, he and a former teammate have reached a settlement with the league, who they accused of colluding against them. The NFL and the players' attorneys released a joint statement saying, in part, the parties have decided to resolve the pending grievances. The resolution of this matter is subject to a confidentiality agreement, so there will be no further comment by any party. And joining us now is the lawyer, Mark Geragos. Mark, as we just read, there's a confidentiality agreement in place here, so I really appreciate you coming on. What can you tell us about this settlement?
Nothing.
Nothing at all.
Other than that, I can't say anything at all except it's resolved. And I can tell you that it was a long and kind of unconventional legal journey in the sense that we brought it under the collective bargaining agreement. It was not a lawsuit, a traditional lawsuit. So when some people have kind of said, well, I wish it had gone to court, it wasn't in court. It was under the collective bargaining agreement. So the union and the owners had collectively bargained to have grievances filed under what's called the CBA. And that's how we brought this. And that's where this thing was resolved. And that's the end of that.
And so let me dig into that just a little bit deeper, because I think a lot of people think, why wouldn't he try to take this all the way instead of settling? If he's become this symbol of social justice, some people may look at this and say, well, it appears maybe he just wanted the money.
You know, I saw on that, but they're part, I've seen that on social media, as you do. You can always see it. I've got a whole theory on the social media behind Colin Kaepernick. But the difference between the criminal system, where you're fighting over somebody's liberty, and the civil justice system, which is anything that's not criminal, is all you're doing is fighting over money. That's what a civil justice is. So whether you file in a court, or you go to arbitration, or you go to a mediation, or in this case, a collective bargaining agreement, all an arbitrator, all a judge, and ultimately, if you go to court, all a jury can do is just shift money around. That's what we do. Our justice system is based on money. That's why you hear people say, well, he was only in it for the money. You can't go in. I often tell clients this when they come in. I said, what do you want me to do? I can't go in and go arrest somebody. I'm not a prosecutor. I'm a civil prosecutor when I've got your case. But instead of putting somebody in jail, what you do is take away some of their money. That's what the tort system is. And so in this case, also, in collective bargaining agreements, generally, and this is not just something that's unique to the NFL. In other types of agreements, arbitrations, for instance, you're in a private setting. That's what people are bargaining for. So they're saying, I want privacy. If you're going to bring a grievance against me, if you're going to bring a claim against me, I get privacy.
So there couldn't have been anything public about this.
Right. So that's what I understand, the public frustration. But remember something, in any, whether it's an arbitration, whether it's a grievance, whether it's something else entirely, if you're not in a courtroom, and mind you, federal court, where this normally, if you were going to file, it would be filed, there are no cameras. There are now audios in the U.S. Supreme Court. There's no cameras in the federal district court.
Look, there are reports that your client will receive somewhere between $60 and $80 million. I don't know if you can comment on that. Is that in the ballpark?
I can't comment. I can't say the ballpark. I can't say anything about that.
When was the last time you talked with Colin Kaepernick?
Today. I talked to Colin today. I talked to Colin today not about anything else than his desire to play. It's been a whirlwind. I will tell you, he is the most fit vegan I've ever seen in my life. he inspires me every Lent. To my somewhat trained eye, he looks like he's ready to play. And, you know, I predicted this with Eric, our other client, after we had one of the hearings, that Eric would play.
Within
the last 5 days, he's gotten a 3-year contract. And I'm going to make a bold prediction, although I've been wrong once before on this. I'm going to make a bold prediction that one of three teams picks him up.
Which three teams do you think will pick him up?
I think I think the natural would be if Cam Newton is out, then the natural place to be is to play with Eric in Carolina. I mean, can you imagine? And you've got an owner there.
They both were on the 49ers.
They were both on the 49ers. It's the Carolina
Panthers.
Very good. And Colin Kaepernick.
Testing my sports knowledge there.
Yes, I was testing
it. So he wants to play in the NFL again.
He absolutely wants to play. He wants to compete at the highest level. I mean, this is a competitive young man. I told you before we got on the air, sometimes it's hard for me to remember. I have to kind of dial myself back. He's only 31 years old. This is not somebody who's over the hill. This is someone who's in his prime. You get smarter at that position, and he's wise beyond his years.
And a lot of people would say his actions speak louder than words, but he has been very silent. Help us understand what he was going through in these past couple of years.
I think there's a degree of frustration sometimes when you're getting attacked. I think he finds he's very Gandhi-esque in terms of, and very much kind of, I take inspiration both from Martin Luther King and from others, takes inspiration in being able to channel things or bric-a-bracs that are thrown at him and being able to channel it and find a serenity. He's got a great support system around him. Nessa, who is his queen, as he would say, is wonderful, and she is a fighter like you would not believe, and a protector, a fierce protector. He's got Kat, and he's got Jeff, and my associate Ben. I mean, he's got a great support system around him. His parents are delightful. Rick, I talk with his dad on occasion, and I compliment his
dad. Have the president's attacks gotten to him?
No, on the contrary, I think. And, you know, interestingly, we also started to talk about this. Interestingly, I think the bold move by Nike showed what I have at least anecdotally learned over the course of this. The president's attack was a hijacking of what Colin was doing. It was a perversion. It was really kind of gross. And what the president did was he was trying to take something and use it as a political issue. I think, based on what I've seen, that this was a divisive issue that was amplified by some of the things that we're seeing in the news, some of the things you report on. And we'll get to that in the coming weeks. I think that what Nike showed was that isn't what America is, because, and this was the discussion that we had with Nike, I will bet you that if you come and use him as a campaign spokesperson, you're going to see, and internally, I think Nike understood this and should be commended for it. They understood he speaks to what's best of America, and sure enough, it happened. I mean, for all the naysayers, in the first 2 hours after that ad came out, Nike acquired about $8 billion worth of value virtually as the campaign rolled out. Nike's doing very well. His stuff sells out immediately. There is an appetite, and obviously
he's getting paid through that sponsorship, but
correct.
I'm curious, because you say he wants to play in the NFL. He opted out of his contract with the San Francisco 49ers following the 2016 season. Has he been offered any contract in the NFL, even if he thought it was below market value?
Okay, so some of the great urban legends and urban myths about Colin are is that he opted out. What he did, technically true, but the GM at San Francisco had said, sat down with him and had the conversation. I mean, and I think at some point San Francisco was appreciative of what he had done. He took them to the Super Bowl. There's only, you know, in the last 5 years, 7 years, 8 years, how many quarterbacks have gone to the Super Bowl? You take Tom Brady out, it's probably only probably only seven other guys. He's one of them. That's a very small community. They told him, we're going to go in another direction, and then he opted out rather than get cut, tested the market. Seattle was probably the only place that talked to him. Other than that, no. And that was kind of the frustration with what was going on. I think the issue was hijacked by the president. I think that people kind of cowered in the face of that. And I think ultimately, at the end of the day, there was a brave two or three voices in various spots that said, no, America is better than this, and we're gonna do the right thing. I think you're going to see, I'll make the bold prediction, you can save the tape, I think you're going to see within the next 2 weeks that somebody's going to step up, somebody's going to do the right thing. And you want me to predict who? I will tell you, besides the Panthers, it would not surprise me if Bob Kraft makes a move.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that would not surprise me. And it would not surprise me if his former coach, I'll test your knowledge, also makes a move.
I don't know that one off the top of my head, and I got to wrap it from here. Thank you, Mark Geragos.